Quack quack of ducks, chirp of birds, gibber of apes, growl of bear, croak of frogs, and the roar of lions. Zoos are fascinating to visit. They are the places where we create memories and where we learn more about our fellow beings. But do you know that there are frozen zoos too? Yes, but what makes up the frozen zoos? Why do we need them? Can they really bring back the extinct animals? Join us to visit the world of animals and know all about this library of life, the Frozen Zoo. This was the last male northern white rhinoceros named Sudan, and he died in 2019. Only two members of this subspecies were left behind, Sudan's daughter and granddaughter. Does that mean the end of this subspecies? Well, probably not. Researchers at the San Diego Zoo's Institute for Conservation Research are working to give the subspecies a second chance. But how? With the help of the frozen zoo. A frozen zoo is a storage facility in which genetic material like DNA, sperms, eggs, embryos taken from animals are stored at freezing cold temperature. That is -196 degrees Celsius. By doing so, we can protect these materials for hundreds or even thousands of years. That's because all life activities stop at this temperature, and these biological ingredients remain as they are, and later, they could be used to revive the species they belong to. It all started in the 1970s at the San Diego Zoo by Dr. Kurt Benrique. They started collecting and storing samples of animals of various species. Now it is the world's largest frozen zoo. It contains over 10,000 living cell cultures, oocytes, sperms, etc. In the frozen zoo, there are stainless steel tanks of the size of a washing machine. It's very cold inside the tanks. There are racks inside it, like a building with multiple floors. Each floor can contain hundreds of vials, and in each vial, there are millions of living cells. So it's like you take out one vial, it's a cheetah, and take out another, it's a rhino. Not literally though. Now the question arises, how can an extinct species be brought back to life? Zoos have always been using reproductive techniques for breeding and saving endangered animals. However, they try to save the species which exist. Frozen zoos can go one step ahead to bring back the species which got extinct years ago. Remember the story of the white rhino? Researchers have already managed to turn some of the skin cells from the northern white rhinos into a special kind of stem cell. These stem cells can make any cell in the body, like eggs and sperms, which could then be used to create embryos and implant it into another animal of the species. It sounds like sci-fi, but in theory, it could work. Researchers have already grown a baby mouse from skin cells using this technique. It's worth a shot. Let's hope the female white rhino will become a parent soon. But why are we working on protecting all these species? The history of life on the Earth has witnessed 5 mass extinctions of species due to natural calamities. Currently, we are in the 6th wave of extinction, and that is due to human beings. We have changed their habitats, changed their environment, and whatnot. Using bank samples to promote diversity would give us a chance to change the natural world in a positive way. In short, you can't live alone on this planet. Can you? That's all on this episode of Explained. Do write your suggestions and feedback to us, and don't forget to share this video.